We're here at Faurot Field as the Missouri Tiger football team takes on a surprisingly upstart 5-3 Kentucky Wildcats team.
Yeah, while the Wildcats have been surprising at 5-3, Mizzou also surprised as well, 6-2, and still controls most of their fate here in the SEC.
It should be a pivotal matchup. We'll see as we head into the final month of the college football season.
Saturday brought the likes of Tim Tebow, Paul Feinbaum, and the rest of the SEC Nation crew to Missouri as the SEC Network had television rights for the game. But that nationwide audience would be disappointed early as both teams got off to rough starts. The two teams combined for less than 80 total yards and 4 punts in the first quarter.
Needing a spark on offense, the Tigers turned to wideout Bud Sasser. After driving down to the 3-yard line, Matty Mock found the senior receiver in the end zone to put Mizzou up 7-0 early in the second quarter. Kentucky responded on the ensuing possession, though, as this run from freshman running back Mikel Horton set up the Austin McGinnis field goal, pulling Kentucky to within 4 points.
Following the touchdown, Mock and the Mizzou offense put together another impressive drive. The redshirt sophomore connected once again with Sasser for the duo's second touchdown of the quarter and 8th of the season. Fellow sophomore Aaron Penton closed out the first half with this interception off of Kentucky's quarterback Patrick Towles. Despite the shaky start, Missouri's 164 yards in the second quarter secured their 11-point halftime lead.
The second half saw Shane Ray and the Mizzou defense turn it up another level as Ray himself sacked Towles on a key fourth down in the third quarter, shutting down the Kentucky drive. This was Ray's 11th sack on the season. After a pair of field goals put Mizzou up 20-3, Towles found Jarvis Blue for a touchdown, making it a 20-10 game late in the fourth quarter.
Kentucky built off the momentum from the touchdown to recover this onside kick. Using that great field position, the Wildcats strung together a drive that appeared to be stopped with this Braylon Webb tackle on 4th and 20. But the referees called it targeting. Webb got ejected and the drive continued. Even with the aid of targeting, the drive ultimately stalled with this Michael Shear tackle on 4th down.
Then, after a 3-and-out from the Tiger offense, Ray moved into the Mizzou record book as this sack was his 12th on the season, giving him the most in a single season in Missouri history. Ray's play helped Mizzou get the 20-10 victory over the Wildcats.
So it wasn't pretty tonight, Nick, but Mizzou was able to get the job done as they improved now to 7-2 overall in the season with a 4-1 SEC record.
And for Missouri, this win, coupled with Florida's 38-20 victory over Georgia, Missouri once again controls its own destiny in the SEC East and puts itself in sole position to get back to Atlanta for the second year in a row.
Mizzou goes on the bye next week, but in 2 weeks they're going to travel to Texas A&M for a big SEC East vs. West matchup. From Faurot Field, with Nick Jordan, I'm Austin Huff, 23 Sports.